If she does, just click mute.
All right.
Same with me. Hopefully no one interrupts. What's up, guys? We're here to talk about the Denver Broncos today, about their cut-down day today. So the Broncos made a lot of moves today. So I'll let you go ahead and give your thoughts about every cut. Like, you need like me go over the list?
Yeah, go over the list because I'm not going to remember them all.
All right, so they first released Josh Johnson.
No shocker. He didn't look that good. Compared to Brett Rypien, he was more consistent, Brett. So I think Brett deserved the backup job to Russell Wilson. So Josh Johnson's probably going to be on the practice squad, I think. Because I don't think I'll blame him.
They'll probably bring him back in the practice squad. I think George Payton said he wants to bring him back in the practice squad. I'm glad Brett Rypien's going to be the backup. I thought he looked better with the offense in the preseason.
He earned the job.
Yeah, I thought he was definitely the better quarterback out of those two. So,
and looking at like all the clips and shit, he looks like more like connected with Russell Wilson than Josh Johnson. Like they're talking a lot, so yeah.
I think and that interception this week was not his fault. So if you're gonna bash about that, it's not his fault.
It was a good play by the corner.
Yeah, it was tipped up, so
yeah,
it's not his fault. So yeah, good job. I actually like that Brett Rypien won the job. So next up, I don't agree with this. McTelvin Ejim released.
No, I don't like it. I don't like it. He's gonna be picked up by a team, and he's gonna have a good, like at least be a good backup defensive tackle. Our defensive tackles, like our D line's not that deep, and like we get rid of all of our young depth players, and it's not good. I don't like it.
He just had one of the best games of his career
against the Vikings, you know, and they're not gonna at least give him any reps like as a defensive tackle. So.
That I was like, what? Why would he? I thought he made the team. After that game, I'm like, oh, he has to make the team.
Yeah.
No, they released him. And you keep guys like Purcell. We released him, but he's maybe back. But I don't understand why you keep guys like Purcell around. He sucks. But we'll get into that later. Next up, the Broncos released Quinn Bailey. Really no surprise there.
He sucks.
I mean, backup offensive lineman. He's got third string offensive lineman. No surprise.
Yeah.
They released Jonathan Harris, defensive lineman.
Yeah, he was all right. Probably going to be a practice squad. Maybe he'll be a practice squad guy. I don't know if he'll be on our practice squad, but he'll be signed.
Next on, they released rookie corner Fayon Hicks. What do you think about that?
He sucked. It was a waste of a pick. We drafted like three corners or two corners, like too many corners, and I knew it wasn't going to work out. It was just a waste of a draft pick, you know.
There's rumors that we might sign a corner or something, or claim a corner off waivers.
Yeah, we need another corner because of Michael O's injury. He's a depth guy.
Michael O's going to probably be out till week 5.
Yeah. It sucks. Like, he was doing good, like, from 2020. Like, his rookie year wasn't that bad, you know, ups and downs. And then the other – last year was out all year, and this year he's going to be out till week 5, so you know he has to prove himself after he gets back.
Next up, don't agree with this either. Kendall Hinton. What?
Yeah, he got waived, right?
Yeah, so maybe they bring him back in the practice squad. Hopefully, yeah,
he'll be on the practice squad. If someone claims him, I'll be mad. But yeah, I know he had some struggle. Like he had some games that he struggled, but he's proven in the NFL that he can be a solid number 4 guy. So I don't know why they caught him and kept Cleveland. I don't know why. Why Tyree Cleveland? That's just my opinion.
And he's hurt right now too.
Yeah. So what, they're gonna sign a receiver and then they're gonna put him on IL and then sign the receiver. Unless he's ready for week 1. I don't know.
I thought Hinton could have been like a 4 or 5 good receiver.
Yeah. No, it's just Montel Washington and Virgil.
And then the top 3 guys. And yeah, that's about it. So next up was Zach Johnson, offensive lineman.
Who?
No, but I don't know who that
is. He waived or cut?
I think he was cut.
Okay, then he's not coming back.
Next up was that inside linebacker we got.
What, Gimel?
No, my bad. Oh, just forget that. My bad. Next up was Natane Moody.
Natane Moody. Oh my God. Was he waived or cut?
He was waived, so but he might. Someone might claim him.
Someone's going to claim him. He's a good guard, you know. Like, we keep Graham Glasnow's old ass on the team, but we don't. Like, I get the money thing. I get it's gonna fuck up your cap, but we're going into the season. The cap doesn't really matter till you get to the off season. Like, you gotta put the best players available, and Moody's better, and they let him go. Hopefully he doesn't get claimed, but I wouldn't be shocked.
Stupid.
He needs a guard.
But why Glasnow? He sucks. He's injury prone. The guy almost had a heart attack last year.
Yeah, he can play guard and center.
Yeah, he gets pushed back. We've seen it.
He's gonna have a heart attack on the field.
Still stupid. So yeah, I don't think Moody's coming back. I think the team's gonna claim him.
Yeah, he's too good.
If he magically makes the practice squad, I'll be happy.
Yeah.
But he should not even be in the practice squad. He should be on the roster right now.
He should be on the roster. Yeah, he should be on the roster.
So stupid. All right, next up, we released Dylan Parham.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
Chicken fingers.
You had to leave?
No, I don't want. I'm not eating till like later. I don't want to.
All right, man. I just sorry, guys, about that.
All right.
All right. Next up, we released Dylan Parham, the tight end.
Who cares about him? He's a scrub.
They said he might come back in the practice squad. We'll see.
Okay. Dylan Parham.
No surprise. Next up, we released J.R. Reed. What do you think about that? Safety.
Yeah. He was all right. It was all right, but I'm not shocked. Like, you just picked him up to try him out. And, you know, PJ Locke's better. Stearns is better. And Turner Yell is their boy. It's Nick Mignino's best friend. So he's not going to make the roster.
Yeah. Next up, they released Shepard, the receiver. What the? Who the hell is that?
Darius, the guy they got from the XFL. Darius Shepard. He didn't do that.
He's gone.
Yeah.
Next up, once again, terrible. Seth Williams. What the fuck?
Well, he got waived or released?
Waived, but he might get claimed.
He probably will get claimed. I wish he... I'd rather have him than Cleveland because he showed up more. He played all preseason. He wasn't injured. Cleveland, he hasn't proven anything in the NFL, and he didn't even play in the preseason. So, like, why keep him?
Stupid. There's been a lot of bad releases today.
Yeah. This is, like, the worst day of George Payton's, like, GM Marine, like, in my opinion, so far. Just all the cuts.
Next up, Brandon Johnson. Like, I think he was waived. Like, he's injured right now or something.
He got waived. I don't think anyone will claim him because he's injured, but maybe he'll make the practice squad. But I get not. I think he would have made the roster if he didn't get hurt because he was playing so well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And next up, there was a trade, Malik Reed to the Steelers. What do you think about that?
There you go. They got another pass rusher with TJ Watt. Good job for the Steelers adding to their defense. We got a 6th-round pick. We give up a 7th-round pick. We had too many edge rushers. He was the most valuable guy that they were going to get rid of. So at least we got something for him. But I wish this didn't have to come. Like, I wish Baron Browning was in the middle. You know, and then we could have kept Malik Reed, or we don't re-sign Gregory, and we could keep Malik Reed because Malik Reed, he's a good linebacker. I like him, but you know, I wish him best of luck in Pittsburgh. That's all I got.
Yeah, and the rest are nobodies, so there's really no one more important there. So I'm gonna look back at we released a couple guys yesterday.
Yeah, we didn't release the running back. Or did we?
Yesterday we released Blessed Austin.
Yeah.
The cornerback, he was getting burnt. He was terrible.
Yeah.
We released Jaquan Hardy, the running back. That's what you're talking about.
No, there's another running back.
And we released the guy from the Saints.
Oh, We released him all. He was doing good.
Which, I mean, he might be the practice squad.
I hope
but...
he makes the practice squad. He was fucking. He was doing really good in that game.
Yeah, I know.
We need depth on the practice squad.
The Broncos only carry 3 running backs.
Yeah, that makes sense. Boone, Gordon, and Javonte.
And after we go over the cuts, like, you want to go over the roster right
roster,
now? Like,
yeah.
And they released Sam Martin yesterday. Obviously, we made videos about it, so.
That was a money move. Really.
But now they're saying that it's not money. Like, they said Corus Whiteman won the job fair and square. I don't know what the hell it
is. Sam Martin's proven, but I think it's money. I think they're fucking bullshitting.
Yeah, George Payton said that, oh, it's not money, but I think they're kind of lying.
Yeah. It was the cat, like, save some cap space.
I mean, of course, like I said, like I told you, Corus Whiteman's younger.
Yeah.
He's 27, and Sam Martin's 32.
Yeah.
So that's basically all the major cuts that we made.
Mm-hmm.
Now we'll look up the roster right now.
53-man roster.
Overall, I think it's a very good roster, but, like, maybe some depth concerns.
Oh, yeah.
I know
especially with a few releases and waves that they made.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go every position group right now.
Okay. So let's start off with quarterbacks, okay?
Quarterback.
So we're only carrying 2 quarterbacks this year. We got Russell Wilson and Brett Rippon, which was expected. Why would you carry 3 running backs when you are quarterbacks when you have Russell Wilson?
It doesn't make sense to carry 3 quarterbacks.
I'm fine with Brett Rippon and Russell Wilson.
Yeah, they have good chemistry together, and Brett had a solid preseason. So,
okay, you ready to go running back?
Yeah, running back.
Next up, we carried 3 running backs. Okay, Melvin Gordon, Mike Boone, and Javonte Williams.
Yep.
As expected, not really surprised there.
Williams a starter. Melvin Gordon shouldn't be on the team, but he's the backup. And Mike Boone, he had a really good preseason game against the Vikings. And I'm happy that he's healthy and he'll be a good third stringer who can, like, he'll be a good receiving back. I like him. I like Mike Boone.
Yeah, he looked really good against his old team, the Vikings.
Yeah.
On Saturday. But yeah, like I told you, I rather don't like Melvin Gordon. I was done with him last year and we had to bring him back. Unfortunately.
I hope he proves me wrong. I hope he proves us wrong.
But yeah, solid running back room there. I think it's going to be good.
Yeah.
I think we're going to rely on the running game a lot.
Mm-hmm.
All right, next up, receivers. We carried 6 receivers.
6 receivers.
KJ Hamler, Jerry Jeudy, Montrell Washington, Cortland Sutton, Tyree Cleveland, and Jalen Virgil. So, overall, there's like 4 guys I'd like in here. Like, Cleveland and Virgil are kind of unproven.
Yeah, Cleveland, like Virgil, he's a rookie, but Cleveland, he's been in the NFL for like what, 2 years, 3 years. The Broncos, he hasn't proven anything. I thought Seth Williams
and Hinton
were better than him, but we'll see what he does. Like Tyree Cleveland.
I hope to God that Seth Williams and Hinton make the practice squad at least, one of them, or 2 of them. Because injuries happen. You got to have depth.
As for Montel Washington, I like him. He's a way better returner than Spencer last year. That touchdown against the Vikings was nice, you know, the fake handoffs and the toss. Like, he has a lot of speed. They can use him for gadget plays, you know, running plays, short passes. I like Montel Washington. Like, he's a good pickup. He was a good pick so far.
He looked really good. Looked really good. All right, so we carried 6 receivers there. So next up, tight ends, we carried 4. Dulcich, he's going to go on the IR, though, four weeks. Eric Saubert, I'm glad he made the roster.
Yeah, he deserves it.
Eric Saubert's been very underrated.
He deserves making the roster. You know, he caught a touchdown in the only game I went to. You know, he can block and he can have some offensive games, but, you know, he's mainly a blocking guy, but he's not, like, inept at, like, being an offensive tight end. So that's why I like him, unlike the other guy, the other Eric that we have.
Yeah. And then Andrew Beck. I don't know why they count Andrew Beck as a tight end. He's a fullback, basically.
Yeah, he's gonna be a fullback, tight end hybrid guy. I don't like him because he's not like a pure fullback.
And then obviously Albert O, he's gonna be the starter.
Yeah,
Albert O,
he has to have a breakout year. He has to have a good year. I think he has the ability to do it. Hopefully, he does.
And then obviously we released Eric Tomlinson, but he's gonna come back because
Greg
Dulcich is gonna be on the IR.
So yeah, I think that's a waste of a spot because we could just use Beck as a tight end, third tight end.
I don't understand it either.
Beck can play tight end. I know you're not the best, but you know he's been.
Tomlinson sucks. He sucks.
He sucks. Sucks.
All right, next position, offensive lineman. We carried 9 offensive linemen. Billy Turner, Luke Wattenberg, Graham Glasnow, Dalton Reisner, Garrett Bowles, Cameron Fleming, really?
Oh my God. He's back.
Calvin Anderson, Quinn Miners, and Lloyd Cushenberry. So we carried 9 offensive linemen.
Yeah.
Obviously, the biggest cut out of there was Moody.
Moody, yeah. I think
I hope he comes back, but he might get claimed somebody else.
Yeah. I hope Glasnow. It sucked. He's gone after this year, but I wish they cut him. But you know, I think the only thing they capped him is because he can play center. That's the only reason why. But he's
center and guard.
He's washed.
Yeah, he sucks.
He's washed.
So next up, special teams. We have obviously three guys. You got McManus, obviously the kicker. Corus Waitman won the punting job. And you got Jacob Bowman-Meyer. He fucking sucked that game. You remember that?
Yeah, he better not be pulling that shit ever again.
I can't believe he did that against the Vikings. That fucking was horrible.
He's an okay long snapper, but, like, you can't do that shit in the regular season. That can cost us games.
Oh, my. That was horrible.
Field position is really important, especially with this defense. It's really important.
Yep. So next up, we're going to move to the defense side of the ball now.
Defense.
All right, so we're starting off with the outside linebackers. You got Randy Gregory, Nick Benito, Jonathan Cooper, Bradley Chubb, Baron Browning, and Aaron Patrick.
Yeah.
Obviously, the big one was Malik Reed getting traded away to the Steelers.
For a sixth-round pick.
I think it's sixth-round pick next year?
Yeah. They traded Malik Reed in a 7th-round pick to the Steelers.
For a 6th-round pick.
Yeah, Steelers won the trade.
I think he might start, maybe. I don't know. Maybe it'd be a – we'll see. I know they have T.J. Watt, but who's on the other side of that? I don't know.
They'll have a good season with him. It's a bad trade. But I think it's good that we got a pick at least out of it instead of just cutting him.
Yeah. And obviously the huge surprise was Aaron Patrick. He's probably be more of a special teams guy, more a rotational depth.
He had some nice big hits in the last game against the Vikings, but I didn't expect him to make the roster, but he did. Congratulations to him.
And before we move on, once again, reminder, Baron Browning should be inside.
Baron Browning should be an inside linebacker. Last year, he thrived with Kenny Young. You know, even if he was playing with Josie Jewell, I think he would have a good season with him. But it sucks. Jonas Griffith should be a backup. Josie Jewell should be next to Baron Browning. Singleton should be not on this team. That's Lumberjack. Lumberjacks.
All right, so we're now we're moving on to safety. We carried 5 safeties.
5.
I thought we were carrying like 4.
Yeah.
We carried an extra one. We carried 5, obviously. Craig Jackson. Probably his last year in Broncos. Yeah, he might retire.
Probably in the NFL.
Caden Stearns, good. Justin Simmons. I know you don't like him, but okay. Delaney Turner Yell, the rookie from Oklahoma. He has some good hits, but I know some fans don't like him. But
consistent. Yeah.
PJ Locke, I think he looks good.
Yeah, he's a good backup. Him and Stearns are backups, yeah.
Maybe Caden Stearns starts.
Yeah, next to Simmons.
Are we signing safety?
Yeah.
So there's the safeties. Now we're moving on to by far the worst position on the team, inside linebacker. Okay, so we carry four inside linebackers. Justin Sternad, Josie Jewell, Alex Singleton, and Jonas Griffin. The starters are probably going to be Josie Jewell and Jonas Griffin, I would say.
I'm happy Jonas Griffin is back, you know, from injury, because I don't want Singleton starting. He dropped the pick. You know, he doesn't look like he's just a special teams guy, in my opinion. Stern sucks. And Josie Jewell, he has to prove, like, last year he had two good games and he tore his pec. Like, he has to have a good full season. This is like a proven year for him, really. A really big proven year. I know he signed that contract, but this is a proven year for Josie Jewell.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a bad position this year.
Yeah. Tight ends are going to have, like, high inflated stats.
Not good. So, next up was cornerbacks. We carried six corners. Patrick Surtain, Michael Ojemudia, Kawan Williams, Ronald Darby, Damari Mathis, and Asang Bassey.
I'm not shocked.
Damari Mathis was, like, he's, like, looking good, I heard. So, he's a rookie, obviously.
Yeah, he has time to grow.
The top three guys, obviously, Kawan Williams, Darby, and Surtain.
Yeah.
So, I'm okay with the corners. But, like I said, we might sign in our corner or clam in our corner. We'll see.
We'll see what happens down the line. There's still, like, a couple weeks left, so Broncos play.
And lastly is the defensive line. You got Matt Henningsen, Draymond Jones, Ozurike, DJ Jones, and Deshaun Williams. So, well, what do you think about defensive line?
Purcell is going to be back tomorrow, so. Yeah, I think the D-line is – I like DJ Jones. I like Henningsen and Ozurike as, like, backups, but, you know, we don't have a nose tackle. Mike Purcell is old and washed, so I think they're going to – the running game against the run is going to be hard for the Broncos to stop, in my opinion. So it'll be hard to stop the run, but I like DJ Jones. I think he'll help out a lot.
And what do you think about Deshaun Williams?
Deshaun Williams, I don't know. He's just a depth defensive tackle. He's been with this team for, like, what, 3 years? So he's done an all right job.
Yeah, like you said, Purcell's going to be back. What do you think the starting three is going to be in the defensive line?
Right. Defensive end's probably Draymond Jones, nose tackle, Purcell, and then the other defensive tackle is probably DJ Jones.
Yeah, so there's your 53-man roster for the Denver Broncos.
Yeah.
Overall, I think it's a solid roster.
Still needs to, like, next year and beyond, still needs a lot of upgrades, but I think we could be a playoff team this year if everything goes right.
I think this team is, on paper, I mean, I think it's like a wild card team.
Yeah, wild card team. I don't think we'll win the division, but we need to fight for a wild card spot, and then we'll see what happens from there. Like, that's the goal for this team. We gave up a lot for Russell Wilson. We got a lot of young talent around the board, but, you know, a lot of unproven players. But I think we can get this done and make the playoffs and end the damn drought this year. That's why I think it's going to be tough, but I think they can do it.
Yeah, I believe so. And I before we go, how about those Raiders?
How about them Raiders? Oh, yeah. Alex Leatherwood, he's gone. First-round pick last year. Well, who's the corner? Mullen, like Tremaine Mullen. They got a second round pick. Yeah. At least they got a good, like.
No, it wasn't a second round pick.
What was it?
A seventh.
Because it said former second round pick. I thought they got a second. They got a seventh for him. They got rid of two good players. Well, not Leatherwood, but they got rid of, like, a player that they spend a high capital on, and they got rid of a good corner for nothing, really.
They can't draft. Like, they're the worst team drafting.
They have to get rid of all their first-round picks. They have to trade every first-round pick they have. to get some good players because they can't draft in the first round.
Oh, my. Everyone from the 2020 class was bad.
It's gone.
And then 2021, your first round pick, Alex Leatherwood, was released.
Ruggs is in jail.
Oh, my God. Yeah, they're poverty. Who the hell is going to be the right tackle now?
I don't know. They have to find one.
The Raiders are not good, guys. I'm sorry to tell you that. They're not a very good team.
I wonder.
Yeah, someone thinks they're going to win the division, but okay.
Mm. Leatherwood.
Oh, he's live right now.
Yeah.
Oh,
man. It's going to be a good season. I can't wait till football starts.
Oh, but kind of doubts I'll get copyright.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. So, and I don't know if we haven't talked about this, but Geno Smith's going to be the quarterback week one. Yeah. I feel pretty good about that game.
I'll probably make my prediction like Thursday, like the Thursday of. So, it's a Monday night football game in Seattle. You know, yeah. You guys got
Thursday night. Did you say Thursday?
Monday.
I thought you said Thursday.
I'm like, Thursday.
Well, I say, are you crazy?
No, I'm not crazy. But
yeah, I'm probably gonna do my predictions. Like you're gonna do them by yourself too, and then we're gonna upload them our channels. Yeah. Our NFL predictions for the year.
Yeah, I made my video already. It's uploading tomorrow.
Oh yeah, it's a premiere I saw, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, good video.
I'm a Charger fan. I like my video. That's all I gotta say.
Oh wow. They're gonna say, oh, biased.
They're finishing in last. All right.
Really?
9-8.
Oh my, wow. I was not expecting that.
It's a big mistake.
All right, guys. Are you going to upload this on your channel, too?
Yeah, I'll upload it on my channel, too.
All right, so go check out his channel. Go subscribe to him.
Sub up, Kobe Albertson, Kobe Sports.
Yes, sir. Let's go, Broncos. I know we're a little mad about some of the moves, but overall, I'm feeling pretty good about the season. That
football season is going to start, so.
Yeah, I think it's a week from Thursday is with the Rams and Bills first game.
Yeah, that's going to be a good game.
September 8th when the season starts. Let's go. I'm happy. Let's go, man. I'm sick and tired of baseball season. I want football.
It's just one sport bores me every day. So you add another sport, then you got like something to mix. Balance it out.
All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Hit the like and subscribe. And peace out. See you later.
Bye. Salute.
Have a good night, guys. Peace.